So it looks like dual lens smartphone cameras are basically here to stay. Even our budget blowers are rocking two lenses instead of one these days, and the fresh new Motorola Moto G6 is no different. Like the Moto X4 and the G5S Plus before it, the G6 sports a pair of camera lenses sat there side by side on the back end. The primary 12 megapixel shooter is backed by a secondary 5 meg snapper, and this doesn't offer optical zoom or a wide angle view of the world, it's simply there to allow Motorola's portrait mode to produce a proper depth of field. More on that bad boy later. You can load up the camera app at any time, even when the G6 is hibernating, with a quick double twist of your wrist. Not exactly an ideal maneuver if you suffer from carpal tunnel, for example, but hey ho. Alternatively, if you don't want to look like a bit of a plank, you can simply just poke that app icon instead. Nice. You're thrust straight into the auto mode, ready to snap away using the on-screen shutter button or that volume rocker. Photo capture isn't exactly super nippy, so the G6 isn't quite ideal for action shots, but it's not too troublesome either. You can quickly flip to the video mode or to those bonus features with a swipe up or down the display, while the main screen also houses a number of nifty shortcuts and tools. For instance, you can pop up some handy manual controls if you want to tweak the white balance or fiddle about with the shutter speed at any point. Motorola has also included an active photos mode, which basically mimics the likes of live photos and living images found on other smartphones. This can bring your gallery to life when you're flipping about, which is a neat enough effect if you spend lots of time snapping your kiddiewinks or your pets. And for the everyday shots, we found that the Moto G6 basically performs to the same level set by other budget handsets, such as the Honor 7C and the Huawei P20 Lite. As long as lighting conditions are fine and your subject isn't jumping all over the place like a hyperactive puppy, you can expect some pretty good results. Shots are packed with detail, while colours are accurately reproduced. Snap and vibrant scenes often results in some pretty attractive pics, with no kind of artificial touching up or anything. However, if you are trying to snap a child or something else with a mind of its own, you'll definitely want to take a few photos just in case. Quite a lot of our pics came out blurry when moving subjects were involved. And if lighting conditions are a bit off, the Moto G6 still does its best to compensate. Scenes with a high dynamic range are handled reasonably well, although you will definitely notice some oversaturation in those lighter areas. And while the f1.8 aperture means plenty of light is sucked into the lens for those darker moments, you'll still find that some dimly lit scenes come out quite grainy. Good thing that there's a flash then. Speaking of flashes, you can also shoot some glamorous selfies using that 8 megapixel front facing camera, which actually comes packing a flash of its own, so you can Instagram yourself having an awesome time up in the club. Like the rear-facing camera, however, this snapper once again struggles with imperfect lighting conditions. The Moto G6 sadly cannot shoot at 4K Ultra HD resolution, although it does support full HD at either 30 or 60 frames per second. If you want a bit of that 4K action, you'll have to upgrade to the Plus model. Still, detail levels are again strong at that full HD level, so your home movies will definitely look reasonably sharp when viewed back on your telly. Strong light can again result in oversaturation, and you can expect a fair bit of lens flare on a sunny day. But still, that lens does adapt well to changes in focal distance, and the digital image stabilization helps to cut down on any annoying judder. This is typically stronger at 30 frames per second, although a footage at the maximum 60fps setting wasn't too rough. Motorola has also done a bit of a Huawei and absolutely stuffed the G6 full of bonus camera features. So for instance, right there on the main camera screen, you have access to the object recognition tool, which can analyze anything that you shoot and provide links for more information or to buy something similar. This is very much a hit and miss tool in real life, however. Sometimes it can accurately guess what it's seeing, helped along considerably by any visible logos or labels that you snap. However, most times you get a vague set of results, such as yellow lamp or green plant, and other times it is just downright wrong. Flip into the modes window and you'll find plenty more to play around with. Our old favourite, the spot colour feature, is thankfully back to instantly produce those poser Instagram pics that wedding photographers in particular seem to really love. And likewise, there's slow motion and time-lapse video modes, which do basically what they say on the tin. However, it's Motorola's version of the portrait mode which most intrigued us. This feature uses both lenses to lock on your subjects and then blur out the background to really help them to stand out. You can even change which part of the photo is in focus in post-edit if it didn't quite come out right. The results are usually pretty good, although we did find that our subject's silhouette was often a bit soft or blurred. The cutoff point isn't quite as accurate as some competitors, such as Huawei Manage. All the same, considering that budget asking price, these are definitely some attractive snaps. So that's our G6 camera review. Don't forget to check out the full in-depth review over at recombu.com and give us a subscribe and hit that notifications bell if you want to be the first to know when our G6 review, as well as our G6 Play and G6 Plus reviews, hit YouTube. Thanks for watching, everyone. Love you!